When you think of American infrastructure, what comes to mind? Perhaps the iconic orange-red cables of the Golden Gate Bridge, or the endless streams of cars rushing down the interstate highways. These are, without question, America's pride. After all, the Golden Gate Bridge was completed in 1937, and the Hoover Dam had already stunned the world even earlier, back in the 1930s. For nearly a century, the Golden Gate Bridge has stood as a symbol of American engineering brilliance. A monument to an era of courage and miracles, when people truly believed that nothing was impossible. It didn't just connect two shores, it connected dreams. The Golden Gate in San Francisco was one of the toughest engineering challenges ever taken on. Against incredible odds, it stood strong for over 80 years. Not just a landmark, but a living piece of American history. But that golden age of American engineering now feels like a distant memory. While the U.S. continues to debate how to fund repairs for its aging bridges, on the other side of the Pacific, China is redefining the very limits of human engineering. Deep in the mountains of Guizhou, a new giant has risen, the Huajiang Canyon Bridge. Before even opening to traffic, it faced one of the most extreme load tests in the world. 96 heavy trucks, weighing a total of 3,700 tons, were driven onto the bridge, while over 400 sensors monitored every stress point, deformation, and vibration in real time. And the result? It passed, flawlessly. In doing so, it didn't just prove its safety, it rewrote the global standards for bridge monitoring and structural resilience. This isn't just a bridge, it's a statement, a declaration that the center of the world's engineering miracles is shifting to the east. So, what makes this bridge a true symbol of 21st century infrastructure? China is leading a once-in-a-century infrastructure revolution, building record-breaking mega-projects at an astonishing pace. The nation's high-speed rail network now extends over 26,000 kilometers, connecting Beijing, Shanghai, Shenzhen, and Chengdu. It has become a global symbol of modernization and efficiency while laying the foundation for long-term economic growth. In 2023, China's investment in infrastructure reached $2.44 trillion, a 6% increase from the previous year, demonstrating its strategy of using infrastructure as the core engine for economic expansion and global integration. These massive investments not only expand global supply chains, but also create opportunities for technological collaboration and innovation, strengthening China's position on the world stage. One of the most striking examples is the Huajiang Canyon Bridge in Guizhou Province, an area once divided by rugged mountains. Scheduled to open in September 2025, the bridge stretches 9,480 feet in total length with a main span of 4,660 feet, reducing the travel time across the canyon from 70 minutes to just 90 seconds. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge is not only a transportation link, but also integrates features like a glass walkway, bungee jumping, paragliding, and cliffside trails, making it a new tourist landmark comparable to the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. Completed in just 3 years, this project showcases China's breathtaking construction speed, its ability to overcome extreme geographic challenges, and its growing strength as a global leader in modern infrastructure. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge is not only another milestone in the history of Chinese bridge engineering, but also a pinnacle achievement in the field of suspension bridges worldwide. On the map of Guizhou Province, you can hardly find any large flatlands. About 92.5% of the province is covered by mountains and hills, containing 1.258 million individual peaks, cut apart by 8 major rivers and countless tributaries that carve the land into bottomless gorges. Building an expressway across such terrain almost means confronting the very folds of the earth head-on. The Huajiang Canyon, located between Liupanshui and Shenshenan in Guizhou, serves as a crucial section of the Lian Expressway. To open this route, engineers face two choices. Either avoid the canyon by detouring over the mountaintops, resulting in a smoother alignment but at an enormous cost, or lower the bridge height by adding more tunnels and steep slopes, making construction far more complex and dangerous. In the end, they chose the most extreme solution, to leap directly across the Huajiang Canyon in a single span at an altitude of 625 meters. At such an extraordinary height and span, ordinary bridge types, such as steel girder bridges, arch bridges, or cable-stayed bridges, were no longer feasible. There was only one answer left, a super long-span suspension bridge. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge has a total length of 2.89 kilometers, a main span of 1,420 meters, main towers rising 262 meters tall, and a bridge deck standing 625 meters above the canyon floor. It officially surpasses the Beipanjiang Bridge, becoming the highest bridge deck in the world. Upon completion, it will cut the travel time across the canyon from 70 minutes to just 90 seconds. But how do you build a bridge that holds the world's highest deck in one of the longest spans? In theory, it sounds simple. Three steps. First, build two strong towers, then install two secure main cables and anchor them firmly. And finally, hang the bridge deck using vertical suspenders. Just like that, a suspension bridge is born. Of course, in reality, it's not that simple. To make the 262-meter-tall bridge towers stand firmly atop the mountains, engineers first had to find rock-solid ground, then drive 24 massive concrete piles deep into the bedrock. How deep? The deepest reaches 68 meters, about the height of a 20-story building. Above ground, each tower, more than 200 meters tall, was divided into over 40 segments. Using a hydraulic climbing formwork system, engineers poured and lifted each segment continuously, allowing the tower to grow upward at an astonishing rate of 0.8 meters per day. At the same time, they poured an enormous concrete anchor block, roughly half the size of Beijing's National Stadium. Why so huge? Because only with its 400,000-ton self-weight could it securely hold the two main cables, which would later bear the entire weight of the bridge deck. This is known as a gravity anchor. On the opposite side of the canyon, however, there wasn't enough space for such a massive structure. So engineers used the mountain itself as the anchor, embedding the cable deep inside a specially excavated tunnel, creating what's called a tunnel anchor. With both towers and anchors complete, it was time to install the main cables. From afar, these cables might look thin, but in reality, each is nearly 1 meter thick, wide enough for a person to walk on. But then came another challenge. How could these enormous cables cross a canyon more than 1,400 meters wide? The answer, drones. A drone first carried a thin pilot rope across the canyon, connecting both sides. That rope was then used to pull a thicker rope, and that one pulled an even thicker one, repeating the process several times until a temporary aerial walkway, known as a catwalk, was built between the two towers. Along this catwalk, engineers began installing the cable strands, each strand composed of 91 high-strength steel wires, each just 5.7 millimeters in diameter. The first strand was the most critical. It served as the reference line for all subsequent strands. Using total stations on the ground and Beidou satellite positioning, engineers kept the installation error within 2 millimeters, ensuring that every following cable would be perfectly aligned and tensioned to precision. And when all 217 cable strands have been pulled into position, they are compressed and fastened together using a cable compactor, finally forming a single main cable. Once both main cables were fully tensioned, the project moved to the next critical stage, lifting the main girder. The main girder of the Huajiang Canyon Bridge weighs the equivalent of 95 Y-20 transport aircraft and was divided into 93 segments, which were assembled simultaneously from the center toward both sides. Each segment weighs 200 tons, roughly the same as lifting an entire blade set of the world's largest wind turbine. What made it even more difficult was that all this lifting had to be done under the constant threat of strong canyon winds. Thanks to a smart cable crane system capable of millimeter-level precision control, the main girder was finally joined seamlessly, marking the completion of the world's highest bridge's main structure. Construction of the Huajiang Canyon Bridge began on January 18, 2022. By April 2023, the first bridge tower had risen to 653 feet. In January 2024, the main suspension cables were fully installed. By January 2025, the main girder was joined, and in August 2025, the bridge underwent a full-scale load test. Finally, in September 2025, it is scheduled to officially open to traffic. In just over 3 years, engineers completed this record-breaking megastructure in terrain once deemed almost impossible for modern construction. During the load test, 96 heavy trucks with a combined weight of 3,700 tons were placed across the bridge, while more than 400 sensors continuously monitored stress, deformation, and vibration in real time. The results confirmed that the bridge meets the highest international safety standards, and through a digital twin system, a long-term health monitoring model was established to track the bridge's condition in real time. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge is not just a bridge. It is a smart megastructure integrating intelligent sensing, digital twin technology, and wind control systems. Equipped with over 400 high-precision sensors, it continuously measures temperature, wind speed, stress, and vibration, with all data transmitted to a central digital twin platform. This enables engineers to predict potential fatigue points, optimize maintenance cycles, extend the bridge's lifespan, and reduce maintenance costs. In terms of wind and vibration control, the bridge adopts a new aerodynamic deck profile and high-performance steel box girders to minimize the risk of vortex shedding and resonance. Additionally, LiDAR sensors continuously monitor wind speed and direction, while temperature control smart chips and cooling water systems embedded within the bridge towers help prevent structural stress concentration under extreme weather conditions. The significance of the Huajiang Canyon Bridge goes far beyond its technological marvel. It shortens the cross-canyon travel time from 70 minutes to just 90 seconds, allowing once-isolated mountain towns to finally join China's national expressway network for the first time. The bridge sits along the Lian Expressway, a 94-mile corridor connecting western Guizhou with the Pearl River Delta, one of China's most economically dynamic regions. Its opening will not only boost logistics efficiency, reduce fuel consumption and vehicle wear, saving millions of dollars in economic losses every year, but also stimulate tourism, hospitality, and eco-industries across a 19-square-mile area. The bridge deck itself incorporates a glass skywalk, bungee platforms, paragliding zones, and cliffside trails. Earning it the title of China's new landmark on par with the Golden Gate Bridge, the service area is named Yundu, meaning crossing the clouds via one bridge. There, visitors will stand 1,000 meters above sea level, gazing across the sea of clouds, and witness firsthand the awe-inspiring power of this engineering masterpiece. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge is not only a pride of Guizhou province, but also a symbol of China's leap in bridge engineering technology. On the global highest bridges ranking, China occupies 8 of the top 10 spots, with half of them located in Guizhou alone. The completion of the Huajiang Canyon Bridge has once again inscribed the world's highest bridge under China's name. Compared with the Milo Viaduct in France, the Huajiang Canyon Bridge wins on deck height. Compared with Japan's Akashi Kaikyo Bridge, it faces more complex, mountainous terrain and wind conditions. Compared with the Golden Gate Bridge in the US, it surpasses it in span, wind resistance, and structural precision. It not only transcends the old definitions of world's highest and world's longest, but also establishes a new paradigm for suspension bridge design under extreme terrain conditions, providing a technical precedent for future projects spanning the Himalayas, the Andes, and other deep canyon regions. Across Guizhou province, there are now over 30,000 bridges spanning valleys and rivers. These bridges not only weave together the high-speed transportation network, but also connect the lifeblood of the economy, cultural ties, and hopes for daily life. Guizhou was once called a place where no patch of land is level. But today, with the opening of the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge, this misconception is being completely rewritten. Through the connection of bridges, mountains are no longer barriers, and even the clouds can be traversed. Millions of peaks now finally have millions of paths forward. The Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge not only links the roads on both sides of the canyon, it also connects Guizhou to its future. In the future history of bridge engineering, people will remember this name, Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge, a miracle descending from the clouds. With a deck height of 625 meters, it sets a new world record. Built in just 3 years, it demonstrates the power of China's infrastructure. And with digital intelligent management, it opens a new era in bridge engineering. It is more than just a bridge. it is a signal that China is leading the next era of human infrastructure. As the sun sets over Guizhou's mountains, its towers gleam like beacons of a nation's progress. A symbol of China's relentless pursuit of innovation, and a reminder that no peak is too high, no valley too deep, when human determination meets engineering genius. The world's highest bridge, the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge, stands as proof that the future of infrastructure has already arrived. So what do you think? Is this the dawn of a new era of engineering? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more stories of the world's most extraordinary megaprojects. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.